Hello. A TV with this fault will not turn on. You will hear some clicking and that's it. Measuring the output voltages from the power supply board will show us the power supply turns on and then off right away. The clicking we hear is the relay on this power supply board. The input current is initially limited by the two white resistors to the right, and the relay contacts short these resistors later when the TV is turned on. The input voltage goes then to a bridge rectifier and a boost and power factor correction circuit. And then there are four smaller DC-DC converters for VS, VA, and one for the 5-volt standby voltage and supply for the DC controller chips, and another one for other low voltages. To the left you see several secondary rectifiers and filter capacitors. In order to test the power supply board, we connect two switches to the leftmost connector on the board. This will allow us to turn on the relay and VS separately. First we measure the input voltage after the main bridge rectifier. It's 160 volt. When we turn on the TV, the voltage goes up to 360 volt. That means the boost circuit works. We also have a 5 volt standby voltage, but none of the other voltages is working. They use an MR2920 controller chip for the VA and for the other low voltages. Here we see that the input relay is powered by the same voltage that powers the MR2920 controller chips. According to the data sheet, the minimum starting voltage for VCC for this controller chip is 14 volts. Even though the voltage coming from the standby power supply is higher than 15 volt, the voltage for the IC is lower than 14 volt when we try to start the TV. We heat up the standby power supply and observe the output voltage. It changes quite a lot. It wouldn't have to be a capacitor problem, but that's the first thing we will check. And indeed, the cap is very sensitive to temperature changes. We replace it. We now have 5 volt, 12 volt and VA working. We replace all other small electrolytic capacitors between the two big heat sinks too, as a precaution. That's 8 in total. But VS still doesn't work. There's no datasheet available for the controller chip MR5060 for VS, but we assume the starting voltage to be similar. Here's part of the circuit around the MR5060. We supply only the MR5060 circuit with an external power supply and slowly increase the voltage. The chip starts oscillating at above 16 volt. The voltage coming from the standby power supply will never get so high, so we assume the chip is defective. We can get it from AliExpress or from maybe from eBay at a cost of $6 with free shipping. And it works. That was all there was in this power supply, a few electrolytic capacitors and a controller IC. Thanks for watching and good luck with your repair.